हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल द एक्यू ट्रेडर। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दैट हाउ डू वी एनालाइज निफ्टी अप मूव टुडे बेस्ड ऑन आवर इंट्राडे सेटअप वी शेयर्ड अर्लियर इन द वीडियो। वी रिकॉर्डेड वीडियो इन हिंदी। फ्रेंड्स, दिस वीडियो इज आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग इन इंग्लिश ऑन द रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ आवर मेनी फ्रेंड्स हु मैसेजेस दैट वी शुड रिकॉर्ड वीडियो इन इंग्लिश एज वेल because they are not understanding Hindi properly. So friends, I am trying to record this video in English, and first of all I'll share my intraday setup, then we will discuss that how do we analyze Nifty up move. So friends, before proceeding further, we have a disclaimer. Intraday setup. Our intraday setup is 5 exponential moving average. We use indicators. Like the first indicator is 5 period exponential moving average. We have a usage that we'll find it a trend. We'll find a trend with it. Like if any candle closes above 5 exponential moving average period, we consider it as bullish if second candle is taking support. And any candle closes below 5 exponential moving average and the next candle is taking resistance at 5 EMA, we consider it as bearish candle. So 13 exponential moving average period can 13 we use second indicator 13 EMA. It is used for providing support and resistance. Friends, in any case, if candle is in any case in a trend, if candle is closing below, like in bullish trend, if any candle is closing below 5 exponential moving average period, so that candle should take support at 13 EMA and should bounce again to bullish. So we are using 13 EMA for support and resistance. We will not consider that trend as bearish or neutral unless the 13 exponential moving average period any candle closes below 13 EMA. Third indicator we use is Bollinger band, that is used for targets and volatility. Like the upper Bollinger band, normally we use it like the upper Bollinger band is target, lower is target, and the volatility, the wider the Bollinger band, the higher the volatility. So we are using in this way. Fourth one is VWAP, volume weighted average price, that is used for bullish or bearish bias. Like if the price is trading above VWAP, that is considered as bullish, and the price is trading below VWAP, that is considered as bearish. And the divergence of price, like the how far the price is trading from VWAP. Like there is a tendency when the price is trading too far from VWAP, it will come towards VWAP. So we will have a reversal trade there. So we are using VWAP in this way. Friends, I am finding advantage of this setup. This setup I am using since long, and I am finding this setup very useful in the case that we are having very small stop losses and we are having big targets. So I'll show you Nifty future chart today of today's expiry, that is 18th June 2020. Time frame we use is 15 minutes. So friends, I mentioned here at closing of 11:45, At this green candle, we have taken a bullish trade, and you will see how beautifully that bullish trade triggers, how beautifully that all candles are taking support at 5 EMA. So what happened at 11:45? Why 11:45? So friends, we will see that our price is opening, our Nifty future has opened today at lower Bollinger band, and you will see in the preceding candles it is taking support there, and this candle, please see this candle, it has taken resistance from mid Bollinger and again has taken support on VWAP, thus forming a higher low, that the low, the primary low and the secondary low. So the higher low, thus forming a higher low and taking support at VWAP. So after closing at above Bollinger band, we are having a bullish trade. So I have written here in detail as well that at opening at lower Bollinger band, price is having support at VWAP. So that is setting a bullish bias. Rejection at 10:15 candle from mid Bollinger. I had shown you there. And support at VWAP with higher high in price action confirms the bullish trend. So the rejection here and support taken at VWAP and thus forming a higher low here. So VWAP with higher low in price action confirms the bull action. At 11:45, breakout of higher high happens. Friends, this is first high of today's candle, and this is second high where we are watching the rejection. But that at 11:45 we are seeing the breakout. We are seeing the breakout of that higher high as well. Plus, there are few other parameters which insist us to take that bullish trade. That what are them? They are closing above 5 EMA and above VWAP, trends finds to be bullish, support of mid Bollinger and the crossover of 5 and 13 EMA making ascending angle of 5 EMA. Friends, I am using the angle of EMA, 5 EMA very much. Like here we will see the 5 EMA angle is ascending. So we will have a prediction that the trend should go bullish. I hope you understand and pardon me if I am saying something wrong in English. So friends, is that enough? Is that enough to take our trade, bullish trade? If we say yes, then our checklist for momentum trade is fulfilled. We are having 5 EMA support, we are having 13 EMA support, we are having candle above Bollinger band, we are having candle above VWAP. So our momentum checklist is fulfilled. And we are in the trade. You can backtest, friends, you can backtest this strategy and try at your own. And if we say no, we will not take that bullish trade. We are not fully convinced. So why should we not fully convinced? Because we should have a stop loss. Before taking a trade, we should have a stop loss as well. So friends, stop loss we can consider is to be VWAP or to be 13 EMA or to be closing below Bollinger band or to be the low of bullish candle where reversal happens. We can take any of the stop loss as per our strategies. So friends, thank you for watching our video and you can mail us any query at theacutetrader@gmail.com and you can follow us on Twitter @acutetrader. Thank you for watching.